The story of Pompeii haunts many people's imaginations, largely because of images like this. People buried in ash, their terror frozen in time. Pompeii director Paul Anderson visited the ancient city and saw the plaster casts firsthand.
There are these two intertwined bodies, and the lovers are kind of just looking at one another.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله وكفى وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على عباده الذين اصطفى وبعد.
Now our topic today, إخواني, is about Lut عليه السلام. It's about Lut عليه السلام. And Lut grew up in the same household as Ibrahim. And he loved Ibrahim, his uncle, so much. And he got attached to his uncle Ibrahim alayhi salam. And when Ibrahim alayhi salam was casted in the fire, and Ibrahim alayhi salam came out of that fire unharmed, untouched, because Allah, the Lord of that fire and the Lord of this universe, ordered that fire, or fire, be cool and peaceful on Ibrahim. And the fire obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he saw that Lut, and not only Lut, the whole tribe and the whole city saw that. And Lut was the only one from among all those people who believed in Ibrahim. And Ibrahim alayhi salam, he migrated from where he was in Babylon, in Iraq. He went to Syria, and then from Syria to Palestine. Who followed him? Lut. On the way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reveal to Lut and revealed to Ibrahim alayhi salam, and the duty of Lut alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will choose Lut as a prophet and a messenger, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send Lut on a great mission. And the mission of Lut was very tough and hard, extremely hard. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Lut to a place called Sadum. At that time was called Sadum. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Lut alayhi salam on a mission, on a job, on a task, on a message. And that message of his to call the people of Sadum back to Allah. And who are these people of Sadum?
And then he directly mentioned to them what they were doing and how wrong it was. أَتَأْتُونَ الذُّكْرَانَ مِنَ الْعَالَمِينَ وَتَذَرُونَ مَا خَلَقَ لَكُمْ رَبُّكُمْ مِنْ أَزْوَاجِكُمْ بَلْ أَنْتُمْ قَوْمٌ عَادُونَ. How can you engage yourselves with the same sex? How can you engage in acts of immorality with the same sex? And how can you prefer them over the females? Indeed, you are a people who have transgressed the limits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Lut alayhi salam said to them directly, أَتَأْتُونَ الْفَاحِشَةَ وَأَنْتُمْ تُبْصِرُونَ. How can you engage in homosexuality, and not only that, but in full view of everybody? Astaghfirullah. You are shamelessly engaging in it whilst people are watching. People are looking at you. You have no shame. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Lut alayhi salam looked at his people and he said, قَالَ إِنِّي لِعَمَلِكُمْ مِنَ الْقَالِينَ. Oh my people, I disassociate myself completely from whatever you are doing. I am not a part of you, and I will never engage in this, nor will I ever condone it. And I want to make it clear that I oppose you very strongly, and I'm warning you of a severe punishment to come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَأَسْرِ بِأَهْلِكَ بِقِطْعٍ مِّنَ اللَّيْلِ وَلَا يَلْتَفِتْ مِنْكُمْ أَحَدٌ إِلَّا امْرَأَتَكَ. Go you now by night. Leave this community and go as far as you can, and do not turn back at all. Don't even turn back to look at them. Besides your wife. Besides your wife, meaning your wife might join you, but she will turn back and receive the punishment. Or your wife will not join you. One of the two things. Whatever it was, Allah knows best. So Lut alayhi salam immediately left because he was told, إِنَّهُ مُصِيبُهَا مَا أَصَابَهُمْ إِنَّ مَوْعِدَهُمُ الصُّبْحُ أَلَيْسَ الصُّبْحُ بِقَرِيبُ. These people's final time is at daybreak. Morning, early morning. Isn't that so near, O Lut? It's so near. You just go away. Go as fast as you can and as far as you can. Just go, you and your family. So he took his daughters and he went. Now what happened? Allahu Akbar. These were the people who were punished in the biggest way. They had three different punishments for one nation. Allah says, فَأَخَذَتْهُمُ الصَّيْحَةُ مُشْرِقِينَ. As that battle ensued, early morning, they had the awful cry and it was so loud, it started shaking them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, He instructed the angel Jibreel, who was one of them, to get back into his original form.
Jibreel alayhi salam, from the edge of his wing, will grab the whole city. From the edge of his wing, will grab the whole city, lift it up all the way to the heavens, that the angels heard the people of Sodom in the heavens screaming and crying, and the people of Sodom heard the tasbih of the angels. And he twisted the whole land and collapsed to all on the ground.
فَجَعَلْنَا عَالِيَهَا سَافِلَهَا. We turned them totally upside down, completely. We made the top the bottom, and the bottom the top. That's what Allah says we did. The tip of the wing of our angel, Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam. وَأَمْطَرْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ حِجَارَةً مِّن سِجِّيلٍ. Allah says, and then we sent those stones which were baked. It's like rock-like stones, meaning slightly larger than a general stone, a little bit smaller than what we would term a rock. Each one had the name of an individual engraved on it. They were already named. Each one had something engraved on it from Allah. This one for that man, this one for that man. It came in an arranged manner. So the stones began to come from the sky. When one hit one, the other was looking, and suddenly another started following this one. And it hit him, and the third was looking, so the third one hit the third, and the fourth and the fifth, until in a very, very short time, the entire community was totally destroyed. There was also one of these for the wife of Lut alayhi salatu wasalam. So Allah says, firstly the awful cry, then we turned them upside down, and then we had the stones rain from the top for every single one of them. Allahu Akbar. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about this. Allah says, وَلَقَدْ أَنذَرَهُمْ بَطْشَتَنَا فَتَمَارَوْا بِالنُّذُرِ. Lut alayhi salam warned them a lot, but they didn't believe him. And they tested his guts, in the sense that they continued. And they continued harming him, and they continued engaging. They didn't want. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, look at these people. Look at how they've been punished. And do you know what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the fact that they are still there. Allah says, these people of Lut alayhi salam, we have kept them, we have kept their signs there for all of you to see who come after them. So today you go to the Dead Sea, Allah says, we've kept it as that. You will see what happened to the people of Lut. Go there and have a peep.